It's been days of chaos with the refugee influx at Bunagana border near Kisoro, where thousands of Congolese entered Uganda fleeing conflict back home. Fighting broke out between the M23 rebels and the armed forces of the Democratic Republic of Congo on Sunday.
Starting with today, they must be moving either back to Congo or to Nyakabanja camp. Because we cannot just keep them in that school where the children are supposed to attend the class.
Gunfire continued to rock Bunagana early in the week but subsided towards the weekend. Security sources confirmed the heavy influx of asylum seekers arriving in Uganda seeking safety, and estimated at least 13,000 people had entered the country.
Now, with their intelligence information.
On Thursday, a joint security meeting resolved that it was safe for Congolese to return home and gave them an ultimatum of 2 days to cross the border or stay at the Nyakabande Transit Center.
They are free to move.
The asylum seekers were scattered in Bunagana, Muramba, and Nyarubuye. Heavy gunfire rocked Sabinyo ranges, especially in the areas of Runyonyi, Chanzo, Bugusa, and Chengerero, just 4 kilometers from Bunagana border in the North Kivu province. The shootouts continued as more asylum seekers arrived.
17, 18.
Not far from the battleground, schools and markets were closed. The asylum seekers were handled by various security agencies and the United Nations High Commission for Refugees. The fighting came barely a week after M23 accused the army of waging war against it. Shanzu and Runyoni were the last readouts of the M23 before its fighters were chased out by Congolese and United Nations forces into Uganda and Rwanda in 2013.
The number is still big. The number is still very big. When you go in the forest there, you can be overwhelmed. The number is still big.
The March 23 movement, often abbreviated as M23 and also known as the Congolese Revolutionary Army, is a military rebel group based in eastern areas of the DRC, mainly operating in the province of North Kivu. This report was compiled by Kate Atuzarirwe for the news.